family enters. Technical difficulties. Thank you, and please be seated. On behalf of Mary's family, I thank you all for gathering this afternoon in the celebration of her life. Following the service, you are invited to join the family in the hall upstairs, and to get there, you go all the way down to the end of the building and up the stairs for a time of refreshments and a time to visit. I'm going to start right now by a little housekeeping piece. We've had a little water damage in the basement that's meant that the downstairs washrooms right now are not usable. So when you're up at the lunch, there is one washroom up there. It's an accessible washroom. If that's got a lineup, feel free to come back down here. There's the three down here on the main floor. Also, a quick apology. We hope to have some recorded music to play when the family was coming in. And we seem to be affected by some technical gremlins that are baffling us. It happens, and so hopefully the PowerPoint later will work, and if it doesn't, it will be played upstairs as well, so you'll get to see it, just not quite sure when. And so with that, we do gather here to grieve a loss. We gather to comfort each other in this time of sorrow, but also to give thanks and honor the life of Mary Louise Latimer. We gather to offer our support and our love to her family and all her friends. Let us join our hearts in prayer. Creator God, creator of all life, you are at the heart of life and all that happens in our world. We give thanks for your presence and ask that you would help us to accept death as a part of life. Help us to trust that just as Mary is safely held in your everlasting arms, so you also hold each one of us as the feelings of loss and grief threaten to overwhelm. May we know that just as Mary abides in your love, that same love is available to each and every one of us here. And just as a mother comforts her child, we ask that you would comfort us, O God. Just as a father has compassion for his children, we ask that you have compassion on each one of us as we work through our own experiences of grief in our own individual and unique ways. Amen. I'm going to invite Kevin up to offer words of tribute, and then following Kevin, Mary's granddaughter, Tennille, will speak. Thank you.
Mary was born September 10th, 1933, at Innisfail to Lester and Marion Wagers, where they farmed just north of town. Mary was the youngest of the family, of seven brothers and one sister. She was predeceased by her parents and brothers Jack, Robert, Lester, George, Art, Ralph, and Tom, and is survived by her sister Maud. She is survived by her husband Marvin, sons Kevin, Carolyn, Dale and Debbie, Dwayne, and grandchildren Shaston, Tennille, Tyson, Morgan, Justin, Allison, and Heather, along with five great-grandchildren. She graduated grade 12 in Innisfail and then went to work for the Innisfail Province paper as a secretary until she was married. She met Marvin Latimer at a dance at the Antler Hill Community Hall and was married February 6th of 1960, where she moved to the family farm east of Bowdoin into the Nisbet district. It was a mixed farm with cattle, grain, and hogs at that time. Together, they raised three boys, Kevin, Dale, and Dwayne. In 2009, they retired to Innisfail and bought a house with the sale of the main farm. She passed away January 27th of 2024 at the Sunset Manor, where she had resided for the last 5 months. The farm they originally settled at had purebred shorthorns, but in the early 70s, the herd was changed over to Limousin, and eventually to purebreds, of which she got involved in with her own herd of purebred limos and joined the Canadian Limousels. She was an avid gardener and always had a big potato patch along with her vegetable garden and raspberries. She had a love for all the dogs and cats at the farm and especially enjoyed their dog Tip, who they took to town when they moved. For sports, she enjoyed cross-country skiing, curling, and biking. And every Friday, while her mom was alive, Mary would go to do her grocery shopping and then go pick up her mom and bring her back to the farm. Then after supper, we as a family would take her mother home and go visit one of her siblings for the night. Every fall, when we had the feedlot, we would go out to Radium and Dad would go to the ranches to buy feeder cattle, while Mom would take us kids to the hot springs for the weekend. When us boys were brought into the farm and we expanded our grain operation, she would do meals in the field for the harvest crew and deliver these to the field, which was a big challenge, especially if lunch was also supplied that day when we were away from the main farm. In 1972, Marvin had a back operation, so Mary Bizard and Mom took us three boys and our two cousins on a trip to Great Falls, Montana for shopping. This is where Kim set off the alarm in the Charlie Russell Museum, and someone else had a temper tantrum at one of the many shopping malls, for he did not want to go in, but we will not mention names. They took many trips together from Australia, New Zealand, Dominican Republic, Yuma, Alaska, Branson, and several other trips throughout the States and Canada. They also took several cruises going to the Caribbean, Panama, Alaska, Hawaii, and the Rideau Canal. Mary enjoyed traveling, but more than anything, she enjoyed being on the farm. She will be greatly missed by all that knew her.
First and foremost, I would like to thank each and everyone here today for joining us. I'm Tennille Latimer, one of Mary's grandchildren. You all knew her as Mary, but to us grandkids, we knew her as Granny. As I stand here today and look out at each and every person here, it warms my heart as I know behind every person is a story of life, love, friendship, and kindness. Every experience Mary had in life was one that connected her to each of you, and you became a part of her story. When people talk about Mary, the first thing I usually hear is she's such a sweet lady. And it's true, she really was. From her days on biking around the farm, chasing us grandkids up and down the laneway, to Christmas at Nesbitt Hall with Santa, to picking up raspberries in behind the house and eating freshly dug carrots out of the garden. Each memory with her is one that will stay warm in our hearts. I am so thankful I was able to have the relationship with her that I did. From granddaughter to best friend to caregiver, our relationship was one that was unique and that I will forever hold close to my heart. I was lucky enough to have had the time to spend with her, especially more so in these last few years. From her giving me care when I was young, to me repaying the favor in her elder years, we made some really great memories. And I also quickly learned, as sweet as Granny was, she was also very sassy. I also learned there's no age limit to bubble baths and water fights. I can only hope that when I start to age, I become as sweet and as loving as my Granny was, but with that little bit of sass. Whenever you needed Mary, she was just a phone call away. She was there for every birthday, every holiday. Even if you lived further away, you could always count on that call from Granny. Granny, she never missed a beat, especially when us grandkids came to visit wearing our in-style ripped jeans. She would always remind you that you needed new pants and that I needed a haircut. Our granny, Mary Latimer, was one of the kindest, loving, caring ladies, and we are forever thankful that we got her for as long as we did. 90 years is a celebration. Her story is one filled with love, life, friendship, and kindness. Each of you contributed to her beautiful story. So with that, I would like to leave you with a short page from Edwin Osgood Grover's. I wish you joy. I wish you joy in long years of loyal friendship, of dear companionship and deathless loves. Joy in your quest for truth and beauty. Joy in the quiet and solitude of your own heart when the night comes and restful sleep. Joy of the cheerful yesterdays, of heroic todays and confident tomorrows. Through all your life and all your years, I wish you joy.
Thank you both for those words, and we hope we're going to have a video tribute. Everybody hold your breath. Yes.
Remember when old ones died? assembly rearranged. We came together, fell apart, and broke each other's hearts. Remember when?
I will love and have no fear. this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, and so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace. Yeah, when I get where I'm going,
oh, when I get where I'm going,
there'll be only happy tears.
And I offer to you some words of scripture. First, from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for His name's sake. And even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and you anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows, and surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of God my whole life long. And reading verses from John 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am going, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place that I am going. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask God, and He will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees Him nor knows Him. You know Him because He abides with you, and He will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. May God bless to us our understanding of these words. And I invite you to stand if you are able, and if you wish, to join in singing In the Garden. Please be seated. It's an honor to be here with you today, part of this sacred circle of family and friends, to share and remembering the life of Mary. Over 90 years of living and loving. I know that many of you were here with Mary in the hall upstairs for that 90th celebration. I was told that Mary loved to garden, especially vegetable garden. Actually, I was told that she really didn't have a lot of use for flowers in the garden. Things had a purpose. The garden, though, whether it's vegetables or flowers or those raspberries, the garden can be a place of retreat, a place to be almost literally grounded. Spiritually, it can be a place of renewal and restoration. I shared the 23rd Psalm for you as it speaks of renewal in God's creation. It's a passage that has meaning for so many of us. A lot of us know it by heart. We learned it as children. It offers words of comfort and care in difficult times. It is a prayer that was written by someone who was expressing how he understood God as God who is always with us. Those words, "The Lord is my shepherd," speak of a God who guides us through life, who leads us down the right paths and offers us sources of strength and sources of rest and renewal when we need them. And those green pastures and still waters, places that restore the soul, places that offer us healing and solace when we've been down difficult roads. The psalm also speaks of those times when there's shadows, when there's darkness in the valley. Those can be times of doubt or fear or even grief. Shadow times, though, can also be times of discovery, of wonder, of mystery. The psalmist trusts that God is with him then, too, even in the shadow times. We hear that in those words, "You are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me." The light of God's love just keeps shining forth, even when the road is difficult. Probably especially when the road is difficult. And then I shared those pieces from John's gospel that remind us that God cares for us in such a way that there are places prepared for each and every one of us. That as we leave this earthly presence, God will gather us up in love and all will be well. That is the ultimate gift of hospitality and compassion. And I was drawn to this passage as I learned of the ways Mary, along with her beloved Marvin, cared for her family over the years, the ways she prepared places for her family to flourish and grow. The gospel writer also reminds us that God gives us the Spirit, or the Advocate, the Spirit who abides with each one of us throughout our lives, guiding us as well, holding us in love. The Spirit, we know, was with Mary throughout her life, just as the Spirit is with her now, throughout the mystery that is death. That same Spirit is with each and every one of you that will miss Mary's presence among you in the days and the weeks and the months ahead. Trust that God's Spirit with you. Take the time you need to grieve, to walk through that grief. There will be times that your memories will bring tears, and there will be times when you can smile and appreciate the joy of having had Mary in your lives. Remember the person she was. Honor her by reflecting the care that she showed you. Share that kindness with others whenever you're able. Remember how her love touched you. And may God continue to bless you as you journey through times of remembering and celebrating your beloved Mary. Amen. And we join our hearts in prayer. O God of hope and healing, grant that we may go from this place empowered by your loving presence. May your compassion open us to the healing that comes when we do take time to remember and celebrate the lives of those we've lost. Be with this whole family today and always. We lift up in prayer Mary's beloved Marvin and her family, Kevin and Carolyn, Dale and Debbie and Dwayne, her grandchildren, Shaston, Tennille, Tyson, Morgan, Justin, Allison, and Heather, as well as her five great-grandchildren, her sister Maud, and many other extended family members. Keep all who loved Mary in the embrace of your love. Bring them comfort and peace. Help us all in the days ahead to value the hope that comes with new beginnings, and to know that though Mary is no longer with us, those who knew her will always and forever be blessed by the legacy of her quiet, loving nature. May we always feel your presence with us, O God. Hold us in your love as together we share the words that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And I invite you to stand if you're able and join me in singing How Great Thou Art. And if you would please remain standing for our blessing. We trust that Mary has been received into the peaceful and welcoming arms of God. We trust that she has gently gone into God's presence and has joined that communion of saints that surrounds us all. May she rest in peace. And for you, as you go from here, may God be your comfort and your hope. May God be your light and your strength. And may the blessing of God remain with each and every one of you this day and forevermore. Amen.
You are a sunbeam, and you will shine forever. Forever in our hearts now that you're gone. You are a sunbeam, and you will shine wherever. Wherever your soul decides to roam. I wish you could have stayed a little longer and shone more of your sunlight in our lives. But having known you, I can feel a little strong, remembering the sunshine in your eyes. Sunbeam, you are gone but not forgotten. You all carry with me every day. Think about the smile you smile so often. Until I see you once again someday. You are a sunbeam and you will shine forever. Forever in my heart now that you're gone. You are a sunbeam and you will shine wherever. Wherever your soul decides to roam. Stay a little longer and shine more of your sunlight in our lives. Having known you, I can feel a little stronger, remembering the sunshine in your eyes. Sunbeam, you are gone but not forgotten, and you I'll carry with me every day. Think about the smile you smiled so often. Until I see you once again someday.
There's an elevator. Okay, sorry.